It happened, Apple unveiling a $1,000 iPhone X. Brian Sozzi, does this push Apple not to a $1 trillion valuation, a $2 trillion valuation?
I mean, have you been saving your money to buy this phone? I mean, this is a big investment here, Scott.
$1,000.
Yeah, $2 trillion, yes. And if you think about it, it's not as outrageous as you think. This is about 60-65% move from here over the next 12 to 18 months. Look,
we're
what Apple
did. We're at $840 billion right now in
exactly,
terms of market
$2 trillion all the way. And there's a couple things why I think this can happen. Apple came out today, higher prices across the board. I mean, you're looking at almost $1,200 after tax and accessories for the iPhone X. Mind-blowing, this price is crazy. They segmented the market. They have a whole bunch of new versions of phones, and they're offering new features. The old question with Apple coming into this event, did they offer something fundamentally different? They did, $2 trillion.
But with those higher prices also, I mean, we don't know if the margins went up, right? The margins typically on an iPhone are what, 46%, something like that? So I don't know if that goes higher. We'll have to see.
Well, but now that's you get an Apple stock analyst.
That's
me.
A big question, though.
It is. You know, they did pack a lot of stuff into this phone. I'm not too sure about margins, but looking at how the Apple supplier stocks are trading off of this event, I think everybody's making money.
Did the Apple 10 steal the show for you? Were there other memorable highlights that you
there was
liked?
A little good, it's interesting you called the iPhone 10. There was some confusion. Is it the iPhone X? An Apple person on the stage called it the iPhone 10. Does the iPhone 9 skip the generation? I have no idea.
I don't think there's an iPhone 9. In fact, I wrote that on Twitter. Is there an iPhone 9? And no one really knew.
I have no clue. I think Apple did enough here. $2 trillion, if not more than that.
I love, though, the Steve Jobs theater. That was pretty incredible. We also saw Apple give a sneak peek at the campus, and they also put retail front and center. They put their retail head, Angela Arendts, on stage. She was the former CEO of Burberry. It was interesting to hear that perspective.
You won't hear a lot talked about Angela's performance on the stage, but I think it was very well. Apple is opening these giant flagship stores just like Starbucks is doing. They want you to go there. They want you to learn how to code. They want you to hang out in the store in 4 or 5 hours, buy a watch, buy a tablet, buy this new $1,200 iPhone. They want you to do everything. Ultimately, retail right now, if you don't have a destination like an Apple store or like these new Starbucks roasteries, there's no reason to go there.
And with $250 billion in cash, they have the money to open these stores.
They can do whatever they want.
Yeah. Or, all right, I have my iPhone 6S.
Is that a 4?
6S, so 2 years old. Should I upgrade? I mean, should I get the 8 or the 10? I don't know.
I think you already know what you're going to do. You're going to end up spending $999 plus on an iPhone. And we have a great piece up on the street right now by Lindsay Rittenhouse. If you're spending this much, you're not going to drop $1,000 up front. I mean, you might. You have all the money
in the world. Really? I didn't know that.
But you have the installment plan. You're dropping $50 each month. It's going to come out of some other places. Might be fewer cups of coffee from Starbucks, for example. It's going to come out of somewhere, especially for the holiday season.
All right. Available for pre-order starting Friday. Brian Sozzi, thank you as always.
Thanks so much.